right? So in unit number two, we said about the B trees, B plus trees. Then we covered first, before B plus trees, I have covered the ISM and B plus tree, right? Then we discussed all the algorithms in the B plus tree. And then I have covered the bulk loading of B plus tree. And with before bulk loading, I have covered the key compression, right? So the second unit already have covered in the earlier video. So today we are going to start with unit number three, right? So unit number three is, I am covering the external sorting part, right? So let us find out how DBMS does the sorting, right? And why it needs to do it. So first find out what are the reasons why sorting is necessary to be carried out by the DBMS. And then we will see what are the different ways it uses so that the sorting process is fast. So to find out the reasons, naturally, you know what do you mean by sorting? Either we want the output of my select statement. So whenever I'm putting a select query on my SQL prompt, right, with my condition, right? Now it might be the join and all that, if I'm mentioning more than two relations or three, four relations, and then I'm having where clause, right? Or I may have a correlated query, all kind of things, right? So I'm using all possible the features provided in SQL, but I say at the end I want the order by on the F name, right? So I'm saying give me us results in the order of the names of the employees, right? Or I say give me the list of the departments in the ascending order. Or sometime I say, I want it in the descending order. So when user is requesting, user may want the answers in some order, either in increasing or decreasing. So that time, naturally, DBMS need to do the sorting of the result, right? Similarly, the sorting records is the first step in the bulk loading. As I told you, in B plus tree, when we discussed in the unit number two, in bulk loading, what we do is, we sort the records and then we build a B plus tree, and then, as I said, whenever I'm referring a we or I or you, I'm saying DBMS does it in that way, right? We are learning how DBMS works. So DBMS needs to sort those records because it carries out the bulk loading of B plus tree. And we saw how it is fast to build a B plus tree, right? So that is another reason. So the first reason is the user wants the results in either ascending or descending order. Second one, the user, the DBMS needs to do the sorting because it carries out the bulk loading of B plus tree. So you need to do first sorting and then carry out that operation. There is another important reason where we require a sorting, that is where we discuss about the relational algebra operations called the join. So where we discuss about evaluating the relational operators in query optimization. I think PJ sir might have started that, right? So parallelly we are discussing this. So where we see that how these relational algebra operators are evaluated by the DBMS. So there, in case of join operation, right, it needs the sort, it is like a sort join or merge join. So there are different alternatives how join can is, you know, carried out, evaluated by DBMS. So in that case, we find out that the sorting is needed to evaluate the join operation when the query is submitted with the join. So as we know now these different reasons where the DBMS need to do the sorting, now let us find out how DBMS carries out the sorting. Now remember, I am having either, you know, 100 records, or in the data can be my 10,000 records. So there has to be some effective way of sorting, right? The sorting technique, so that my data is sorted fast, right? So we'll find out the cost also when we discuss these two techniques. The originally which was demonstrated or which was actually the evolved or which was given was the simple two-way merge sort. This is also known as a simple two-way merge sort, right? So we'll first find out there are two techniques. When I say two techniques, the next technique is not totally different. It is a generalization of two-way merge sort, right? So little generalization is there in this. The idea is same, into a merge sort how we carry out, but the generalization is done and then it is named as external merge sort. And we find out the cost, IO cost, it decreases a lot when the generalization approach is used, right? So let us find out, or at this point, let me put it as, there are two techniques for sorting the data, the sorting the records in DBMS, right? The first is two-way merge sort, and second one is external merge sort, which is a generalization of two-way merge sort, and which results in the less cost, less IO cost, right? Where is our cost? When it is reading the pages from the hard disk, again when it is writing back the pages to the hard disk, right, after sorting. So all that counts us as the IO cost. So a file has, suppose, n pages. So my file, whichever I am going to file off, naturally my database, right, my database which is naturally of records, and my file now which is in the terms of pages, right, and my each page, right, is my 4 KB size, and my every page has to be brought into a memory when I am processing it, right, and suppose my file is of n pages. The size, that is, I am saying how many number of records I am having, and I am saying generally my file consists of n pages, and then we evaluate how much cost is involved in these two techniques. So before finding out the cost, let us find out how this sorting techniques works, or how DBMS uses them, right? How does it implemented it? So the first one is, this algorithm we have started now with the first technique, that is two-way merge sort, right? So I am explaining how two-way merge sort works. This algorithm utilizes only 3 pages of a main memory. So what is the first feature of this? It is using at any time the 3 pages of main memory, right? I will show you a figure how it uses it. Out of this, it uses 2 for input, right, and 1 for output. Right? So whenever it is doing the sorting at particular step, it always uses, in other words, at each step it uses the 3 pages, right? Okay. So second point, what we are saying, when sorting a file, the several sorted sub files are generated. So it is not going to see there are so many records, right? It cannot sort it at a time all. So what it is doing, it is sorting the pages of the file first, right? So within a page, whatever records are there, those gets first sorted, right? So for each step, intermediate step, the output which we get, we call it as a run. So we have defined now run. So what is a run? Run is nothing but my output of, right, each intermediate step. So I will have the number of the steps, because in one step it cannot be sorted, because your file is consisting of n pages. See, sorting is not just sorting of 10 numbers, right? You know, you learn it in data structures, then you find in the what is the efficiency of the algorithms, because you are having just n numbers there. And you know quick sort can be used, there are so many types, merge sort can be used, bubble sort can be used, so you know which is how much efficient, right? But now the things are different. I am not sorting n numbers. I am sorting the n records. And my records are across the pages which consist of pages of a file or which belongs to a file. Right? So let us find out how DBMS does it. So we define now the term run. So what is a run? Run, we are defining it as a output of each intermediate step. Right? Now what happens at the first pass? So now we are having number of passes, right? Naturally in any algorithm when we say, right? So in the first pass, the pages in the file are read one at a time, right? After the page is read into the memory, the records on it are sorted and the sorted page is written back to the hard disk. So as I told you, the sorting is done page wise. Each page is brought into the memory. The records on that page are sorted and again that page is written back to the memory, right? So for every page I require 2 IOs. Fine? Okay. Now while sorting within a page I'm sorting the records, right? And I'm sorting it either on salary or I'm sorting it on FNAME. So whatever my attribute is there using which I'm sorting the records, that sorting can be done using any of the sorting algorithm. Right? So it may, your DBMS can use quick sort, or it may use the merge sort, right? Or bubble sort. So it uses any sorting techniques it can use, and it can sort the records on a page. But now what we have done? We have used the sorting techniques to sort the records of single page. Right? Now we are discussing sorting of all the records in a file. Right? So when it is getting a one page into a memory, then the records on that single page, it is using either a quick sort or any other technique to sort the records of that page. Now what happens in the second pass? In the first pass, what happened? Every page was brought into the memory and records within that page were sorted and it was written back. So now what happens after pass? First pass, right? We call it as a pass 0, and then next passes we call it as a pass 1. So pass 0 was getting every page into a memory, sort the records and then write back to the hard disk. Now in pass next, all passes, that is from pass 1, what happens is it takes the output of the previous runs, right? Previous pass, the runs are output, right? So it takes the runs of previous pass, but it takes the runs of two adjacent passes, two adjacent runs. So what it does is, in the first pass, now if it is n pages, I've got n runs. That is n outputs. Every page is sorted. Now I take consecutive two pages and then sorting is done. So both the pages are brought into a memory and then output, the pages are, the records are sorted in between these two pages, and again output is written back to the hard disk. So next all steps, how it continues? See, output of the previous pass are read into the memory. Whenever it is in, it is to the memory, and merged to produce the runs that are twice as long. Naturally, I'm taking one page with 5 records, another page with 5 records. When I'm merging them, now my naturally output will be in double size. So I'm going to get 10 records which are sorted. Right? So I'll show you an example immediately. But let me finish this, the general points, what we're discussing, how it works. So now when it, the twice as long, naturally, because I'm combining both the outputs, one page and second page, and then I'm sorting records in the both the pages and I'm writing into a third page. Pass 0 produces, that is my first pass, will produce the 2k sorted runs of one page each. What is 2k? Suppose for some k, my size is n pages. In other words, my 2k is equal to n. So if I'm saying file is of n pages, suppose it is 2k. Why? Because we are saying how many, it gets reduced half. So we are saying 2k, right? So the pass 0 will produce n sorted runs. It was n, no? Every file had a n pages. So naturally in the first pass 0, I will get n pages only, because within a page I'm sorting the all the records, right? My employee, suppose S name Smith, and Smith all data is there. So I'm sorting Smith, then I'm sorting Jack, then James. So all records are getting sorted, right? But my number of pages were same, no? Whatever input in the first pass. So that will produce me 2K. 2K is nothing but I'm considering for n pages. In the second pass, what will happen? The pass 1 will produce the 2K minus 1 sorted runs of 2 pages each. Here it will be only 1 page because I've sorted 1 page. Now here I'm combining, no? 2 pages, and then I'm sorting the contents of 2 pages. So I will get 2K minus 1 runs, that is outputs, right? Of 2 pages each. So the length of this will be run will be 2 page. Similarly, it goes on, you know, here it goes on decreasing, but the page size will increase. So in the next pass 2, I will get 2K minus 2 outputs, right? That the output in terms of pages, but each output, each run will be 4 pages each. Right? Run, what we define? The output of an intermediate step is called as run, right? So I will get output at this particular pass 2, right? 2k minus 2, you can take it as a 2k as I told n. So this is n, this is n minus 1, this is n minus 2 if you want to simplify it. But my output page, the length will change because I'm merging next. So continue until you get the one sorted rank, until you get the last one, you know, file, sorted file. Now how many pages you will have naturally? 2k pages, that means n pages, because you started with file with n pages, which was unsorted. And your output also will be a sorted file, but with naturally with n pages, but your file is now sorted at the end, right? So let us find out, it's simple. This was general, actually I said the how it works, general, you know, using the nomenclature, how we can define. So when you see example, it is very clear how it works. So suppose these are my records with the, suppose with the student, you know, or the age of the department number or age of the employee. So what I can consider is 2, 6. So let us consider this as the records of the department, employees with particular department, like 1, 2, 3, 9, all these are department numbers. So what I'm doing is, I am taking now a record with 3, record with 4 is in one page, because to illustrate we have just considered 2 records, but in reality it will be, you may have some, based on the size of your record and based of your page size, which is usually 4k, right? 4k is your page size. Now whatever, you know, table you have defined, how many fields you have defined, based on that your record length will be there. So how many records fit in the page? So you consider that there will not be a 2, but there can be minimum 40, if I consider it, right? So it can be 20 or it can be 30 or it can be 40. But to illustrate the example, how it works, the simple merge sort, two-way merge sort, we have considered in the page 2 records. So the first page contains the record with 3 on that column value, right, on that attribute. So that attribute value is 3, and next is the record with attribute value 4. Similarly, all these values we have considered, these are the records, right? So if you see here, again I have got 3, 1. So that means there are 2 records with the attribute 3. It may happen, no? Like department 3, there are 2 employees working. Next is, I am having with 2, there are 2 records if you find it, right? There might be 1 also, or there might be more. So we have a records and we have shown that first page contains, however I went on inserting. So based on that, my pages are like this. Fine. Now when it is sorting, what it is doing, it is first pass, this is pass 0, right? We are starting with pass 0. The first pass is naturally a pass 0, right? So that pass 0, what happens, as we said, it will sort the records within a page. Now it is happening in the pass 0 within a page, right? So 3 and 4, it is already sorted. It will see it is already sorted, 2, 6. 6, 2 will be sorted. Similarly, 4, 9, then 7, 8, then 5, 6, 1, 3 and 2. So now records got sorted within a page, right? What is the next step we said? From the next all passes, it takes the runs of 2 adjacent runs of the previous pass, right? So what are the 2 adjacent outputs of the previous pass? This is first one, second one. Now what it will do? It will sort the records of both. So it will get the both the pages into the memory. Right, that's what we said. If you remember, I say two-way merge sort algorithm uses 2 input pages and 1 output page. So any time when it is working across the passes, always my input is in 2 pages and my output is 1 page. Right, so let us find out, this is my 2 inputs. So what happens, it now combined it will sort. So 2, 3, 4, 6. Now it will consider next 2. 4, 7, 8, 9. Now it will consider next 2, 1, 3, 5, 6. Now at the end what is happening? Only one this run is left out, right? Last one. Because how many I had pages? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So my n value was 7. Right? Here. In the pass 0 I got all 7 pages as output. My 7 runs I had in the pass 0. But now they have reduced to my output reduced because I am merging, no? Both. So I'm getting only 4, right? So we said, no, it will reduce it to 2k minus 1, 2k minus 2, but pages of 2, 2 pages, right? So it gets reduced here. Now let us find out what we are doing next. In the next pass, the same logic continues. So now it will take the runs of previous pass. So it will take these two. So now what is happening? 2, 3 is there, then 4 is 2 times, then 6 is there, then 7 is there, then 8 and 9. So now it is combining these two inputs and sorting it. Similarly, now next two inputs of previous pass. Whenever I am saying output of previous pass is called run, so this is a run. This is also a run. All these were runs of pass 0. This is a run that is output of pass 0, right? So this is the output of pass 1, right? So put it simple. First, what it does in the pass 0, it gets each page into a memory and sorts it. That is pass 0. But from next passes, what happens? It takes the consecutive outputs of the previous pass. And consecutive outputs are known as the runs, right? So it will take the consecutive outputs and it will sort. Consecutive outputs sort. Again, it continues consecutive outputs and it sorts. Now let us find out here. Now it stops it here. Now you get a sorted 5. Right? So now how many passes I require, that depends on how many pages I am having, my file size. Suppose my file size is now with 7 pages. Suppose my file size is of 15 pages, naturally it will require more passes than this. Right? So it will require it depends on what is the file size in terms of number of pages, right? So your n will determine how many passes are required to sort that file. But when my n was 7, then I had this as a pass 0, this was my pass 1, pass 2, pass 3, so total I required 4, right? 4 passes. Okay. It's interesting and it's simple. I hope it is clear, right? Now what we are saying here is, I have put there one comment, see. The sort takes the 4 passes and in each pass we read and write 7 pages for a total of 56 IOs. So what is happening now? This page was brought into memory, wrote back. This page was brought into memory, wrote back. Like that, we have calculated how many IOs we required, right? For this, these both pages were brought into memory, these both pages were brought into memory, and then later these all pages were. So total how many IOs I require is 56 IOs, right? The cost involved in pages. Now let us put it in terms of algorithm now. A theoretical pseudocode it is. You can call it as a pseudocode. So the same algorithm what we are saying, the procedure we have defined it as a two-way external sort. My input is file. Now first is what? Read each page into, this is comment, to you make understand more, right? So read each page into a memory, sort it, write it out. Right? Write it out is read each page from hard disk to memory, sort the records in that page and write back to the hard disk. While the number of the runs at the end of the previous pass is greater than or equal to 1, right? So the output is greater than or equal to 1, then my thing should go. I stop whenever my output is 1. That means I've got the sorted file. That's why this loop continues as long as my number of runs are greater than 1. How do we do that? While there are runs to be merged from the previous pass, what we do? Choose the next two runs from the previous pass. Right? So choose the two runs of the previous pass. Read each run into an input buffer. Right? A page at a time. So it is reading that input buffer. Now sometime what may happen? What is the statement? Let me put it here. Read each run into an input buffer, but page at a time. Right? So now for example here. It is reading now each input, right? Each run, right? This is the input, right? For this phase, for this pass. So here what is the input? That is page itself, only page, one single page. But next on onwards, my input is 2 pages. Now here it is 4 pages, right? So it is reading that input into a buffer, but as a single page, it cannot read all the pages at a time. So it will get a single page into a memory and get that run into a memory, right? Now sometime what happens if you read thoroughly, properly, you know, all databases which uses which kind of sorting, then whether they use a separate memory for this sorting reserved, or it uses which is, you know, free memory in the already OS has already left out memory other than OS. But there are some partitions, memory partition reserved for sorting, sub DBMS uses them. Right? So you can find out like Sybase uses this, Oracle uses this technique two-way sort, or Sybase uses this external way sort, and it uses even separate memory partition for sorting. All that is there. Fine? So now what we were saying is here. What it does? Read each run into an input buffer. It is not like just one page, huh? Because I may have 2 pages, 4 pages, right? So I'm using that buffer, input buffer. So 2 input buffers and 1 output buffer is required for the two-way merge sort. Now merge the runs and write the output to the buffer, right? Force the output buffer to the disk 1 page at a time. So what it is doing? It is merging the runs and then it is sorting the merged run, and then it writes the output to the buffer in memory itself. And then from memory, it will force it to write it to the hard disk, right? So all the pages required of run are brought into a memory. Those all are sorted and write into a buffer first. And then that buffer is again placed back into the hard disk. Okay. So I hope you understood how two-way merge sort works, right? I want to show you one figure before I go for the external merge sort. So that is in this PDF. Let us find out that figure here. So we are seeing Y sort, all that we have discussed. This figure. I hope it is clear, right? So what we are trying to do here is, see, I'm saying pass 1 is, here they have said pass 1. Or in some books you will get pass 0 and then start with pass 1. So read a page, sort it is my pass 0 I will consider. 3 buffer pages are used. Input 1, input 2 and then output. Main memory buffers. Right? So in main memory I am getting 1 input, another input. I am sorting them into the file and merging them, sorting them, and then I am writing into output. And then I am same, again I am storing it on the hard disk. So this is how we are saying it uses 3 buffers. Huh? Don't get confused with 3 pages, because sometimes your runs are, first time they are 1 page, but second time they are 2 page, next time they are 4 page because you have combined two pages, next time it will be 8. Now we stopped at there because my file was off with 7 pages. But if file is with 15, it will continue again, right? So I hope you understood this figure, what we are saying. It uses two-way sort, requires the 3 buffers, 2 input buffers and 1 output buffer, right? Because at each pass, it works in that fashion, right? Okay. Now if we want the same example is here, what I have explained you now earlier, right? But let us find out just if n pages are there in a file, then how many passes you require generally, right? So if n pages are there, then number of passes required are log n plus 1. So if I'm having n pages, then what we are discussing? The number of the passes required, log n plus 1. Right? Okay. So now what we are saying, the total cost involved is 2n log 2n plus 1. General formula. What we said, what I said? For this 56 IOs were required. How do I calculate 56? I put n into this into 7. Then I put log 7 plus 1. Right? So 7 to the 14 and this I had got 4 passes. So 14 into 4, 56. I hope you got it. How many passes I had got? For this example, 4 passes. 4, how I had got answered? Log 7 plus 1. That was my 4. So that 4 I have put it here. And my n is how much? 7. So 7 into 2, 14. 14 into 4, 56. And if you count each, you know, here, because it is a small example where we are demonstrating how things work, how two-way sort algorithm works. So if you calculate IOs, number of IOs, you will get 56 there. Right? But generally, naturally, we find out if my n is 100, how many passes I will require, and how what is the cost, that is IO cost for the pages. I'm getting a formula is 2n, let me put it here, that is 2n, then I'm getting, that is remain same, log 2n plus 1. What is log n plus 1? Number of the passes. What is the cost involved? 2n into log n plus 1. Fine? So, once we know the statistics of this, now we start with the general merge sort. With PPT, and then I will come to that external merge sort figure. So, now what we are doing here is, we are finding how the two-way sort is generalized and the things are more faster. Right? So let us find out. Sorting is a collection of records in some order, all that we said. So this is, sorry, this is our previous discussion. So I'm supposed to start now here. Right? So external merge sort is a generalization of two-way merge sort. Fine? Now there are some modifications done to the two-way merge sort. That's why I'm calling it as a generalization. Right? Let us find out what are those modifications. What happens in pass 0 is read in the B pages at a time and sort. So what was in two-way merge sort? Read only single page and then you get into a memory and sort it and write back. But now we are getting B pages into a memory. So my total calculation gets reduced to, you know, N upon B. Because I'm getting my first pass, how many outputs will be there? Because I'm getting B pages in no memory. In earlier case, it was how? I had N outputs in the first pass 0. But now I will get N upon B outputs because I'm getting B pages at a time into a memory. Right? So in pass 0, read in the B pages at a time in a memory. But once you get them into a memory, in the next passes, what happens? See now, internally to produce N upon B runs. So my output will be naturally N upon B runs. Right? Now, in the next passes, what happens is, it gets the B minus 1 buffer pages. So, in the first thing, what happened? It got the B pages. It sorted them, right? And then that sorting is available. Those many runs are available, N upon B, right? N upon B runs are available to me, right? Now, in the next all passes, what is done? Whatever those runs are there, out of that B minus 1 runs are brought into a memory. So suppose you started initially starting with 4 pages, right? Getting 4 pages at a time into a memory and sorting them. So how many pages you are getting from B from the next pass? You are getting B minus 1 buffer, not the pages. That is all those runs. So if it was you started with 4 pages, buffer pages, now you will be getting is 3 buffers each time from the next passes, right? So let us find out, illustrate the example here. Because with example, it will be more clear to you. So what is happening now, see? This was my input file same, which we considered in two-way merge sort. Now I'm getting the 4 pages at a time. So I got first 4. Instead of 1, 1, I'm sorting them. So I'm getting B pages into a memory. Now what is the value of B here? B is 4. Right? My B is 4 here. So I've got all the 4 pages into a memory. Right? Now it got sorted here. First output run. Did you find here? So what was that when I'm sorting all the records of 4 pages? My record 2 should be first, then 3, then 4, then again 4, then 6, then 7, then 8, and then 9. See here. Right? So I'm getting 2, 3, then I'm getting, I think it has gone wrong while pasting here, but this has to be sorted. 2, 3, then I should get 4, 4, 6, 7. And this 8, 9 should come here. That is some, you know, when I pasted, some error was there. Okay. So that gets sorted there. Now what is happening down? B pages has to be brought. So next B pages are, there are only 3 now of the 5. So it will get all these 3. When it sorts, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Right? Now this becomes the first run. And this becomes the second run of my pass 0. Now next pass is what it does? Get all B minus 1 buffers into the memory and sort it. Now what is B minus 1? 3. But now I've got only 2. So what it will do? It will get both the runs into a memory and it will sort. Right? Suppose there were 3 runs, it would have brought all 3. But with this size, I am getting only 2, right? So it will get these runs into a memory and sort it now this 2. So now see, it got, you know, fastly sorted, no? The number of the IO cost is less. So let us find out what is the cost after we see this algorithm, like our two-way merge sort. What we do here in the external merge sort, read the B pages into a memory, sort them and write out a run. So get the P pages into a memory, sort all the records of the B pages and write the output to the disk, naturally page at a time. Right, there will be 4 pages output only. But that whole together 4 page output is a run, and that run is written to the hard disk, but page at a time, naturally. Now what happens here? Again same condition, until the number of runs are greater than 1. Right, if I am having 2 runs, then again I should continue. Until there is only 1 run. That is my last sorted file I get. So what we do? Choose the next B minus 1 runs from the previous pass. Right? So I am getting B minus 1 runs. That means I am getting, if I started with 4 pages, I am getting 3 runs in the next run, and I can sort those B minus 1 runs. So read each run into an input buffer, page at a time. Again that applies, page at a time. Right? So I am reading all those runs, B minus runs, into a input buffer. Right? So how many input buffer I require? Naturally, in two-way merge sort, what we said? Yes. In two-way merge sort, what we said? We require 2 input buffers, 1 output. Because always in any pass, there is 2 input buffers and 1 output. Right? Whereas here, it will be how? Always it will require N minus 1 buffers as an input. I should say B minus 1. B minus 1 buffers and 1 as a output. Right? So read each run into an input buffer and page at a time. Merge the runs and sort it and write the output buffer and force the output buffer to the disk. The process is same, but the way it is generalized is different so that the IO cost is less. Right? Okay. So let me show you the right. So this is the PDF for the how many buffers are used. I am putting it in general external merge sort. Right. So how it is? I am using B minus 1 buffers. Right. And 1 for the output. So I am using all the time B buffers. Right. In the first also what happened? We brought the B pages in the pass 0. Those B pages are brought and then they are sorted. Right? In the pass 0. But from the pass 2, we merge B minus 1 runs and we should get the output. Right? I hope it is clear. Whereas in two-way merge sort, we have only 2 buffers and 1 output. These are buffers, sir. Don't get confused with the pages. These are buffers. Right? Okay. So I hope you have noted this, the difference between two-way sort and external merge sort. Now let us find out the cost, how it has reduced your cost, right? Cost of IOs. Suppose I am using external merge sort, or DBMS is using external merge sort, number of the passes. How many passes it is getting? Number of the passes? Let me compare it, right? The number of the passes are in two-way merge sort and external merge sort. So what are our 2 techniques? That is two-way merge sort, right? And our next one we are comparing is external merge sort. What is the first difference? Here it uses 2 input buffers, right? And 1 output buffer. The first point. Here it uses
B minus 1, input buffer, I should say input, right? And then 1 output buffer, if I'm putting it right. 1 output buffer, that is the first difference. Second is what?
External merge sort is a generalization of two-way merge sort. What was the cost involved here? The number of the passes, if you remember, second point, right? That was log n, 2 plus 1, the number of the passes. So we are comparing on the parameter number of the passes. In this case, it was log n plus 1. Now here it is how much? C? Because I am taking at a time b pages into a memory. So naturally it will reduce to n upon b. So log b minus 1 n upon b. Right? So I am getting 1 plus log n upon b. Right? So now this is number of the passes. Right? Cost. Now when I am saying cost, what is happening? Suppose I am going with the 108 pages with 5, because I have two parameters here now. How many buffer pages I am taking in the first, in the algorithm, and how many pages I am having of a 5. So here it is demonstrated is, if I am using a 5 buffer pages and I am sorting 108 page file, then in the past 3 only my file is sorted, see here. Right? So only in 3 passes my file gets sorted. So what was I was using? I was using 5 buffer pages, right? And 108 page file, right? In only 3 passes it gets sorted. Whereas in two-way merge sort, number of passes will be surely more. So my I/O cost will be more. So let us find out now the cost. Here is, I am putting here cost, how much we had put there? 2n. Number of cost is what? The number of the IOs. Disk IOs, right? Here it was 2n, then log 2n plus 1. And here it just goes as 2n. To approximate, because it will depend on how many number of buffer pages you are using. But approximately it goes to 2n. Fine? So my n was 108 page. So I get, if it is 108, suppose it was 7 page, then I should get 14 here. Whereas I got here 56, if you remember, right? So here I will get only in 14 IOs, my output, that is 2N. And here example is demonstrated is, I am using 5 buffer pages and 108 page file if I am sorting. Then in past 3 only I am sorting the 108 pages, right? So just imagine 108 pages with so many records get sorted in only in past 3, right? So we compared this. Now this is what the last point I am discussing is, the number of the passes of external sort. Because it depends, as I told you, know, the n is number of pages and this is b is the buffer size. So if number of pages are 100 and if you are using buffer size 3, then how many passes will be required? 7. Similarly, my number of record, the pages are same. But now I am using these 5. That is how many pages I am getting at the beginning. Buffers, input buffers. That I am getting is, number of passes I am getting 4. If I am using 9, I am getting 3. If I am using 17, I am getting 2. Right? So just find the comparison. For example here. This is little very bigger. So let me go with 10,000. If I am using 10,000 record. And if I am getting using only 3 pages to be brought into a memory. I am having 10,000 pages, right? I am getting only 3 pages into a memory to sort, right? And then I am getting 13 passes. Here if I increase, you know, number of the buffers, 5, I am getting only in 7 runs. The 10,000 records are sorted, right?